Hello friends, good morning. So in this video I'm going to give you a brief that how the GST credits are taken by the buyers and its implication on internal audit process. So when supplier does B2B sales, then he or she files various GST related returns. So for example, for B2B transactions, supplier files the GST1 and GST5 forms, which contains the GST related details which he or she has charged. For input service distributors, they file the GST6 return for the distribution of input service credit. Same way, the TDS, TCS related tax deducted at source and tax collection at source, GST7 and GST8 returns are filed by the dealers who have deducted the TDS and TCS. So how to view? Now comes the another return, which is auto generated returns. So basically, when this I have described you the returns which are filed by the suppliers or input service distributors or the dealers. So there's another return, which is GST 2A return. So basically the GST 2A returns, it is auto generated returns on the buyer side. So for example, B2B business, supplier has done any transaction with one of the buyer, and on the basis of that buyer, on the basis of that transaction, and there's in the buyer side, there will be one auto generated return GST2A, which will contain all the GST related information which supplier has entered from his side when he's filing the various GST return which I have just now described. So how to view the GST 2A return on the portal? From the buyer side, you have to write, first you have to log in the GST portals, then you have to go to the return and return dashboard section, then after that you have to go to the financial year and that month which the transactions is late. Then you have to go to the you have to click on the auto drafted details GST2A details section. Then you have to click, it will contains the ask all the suppliers with whom that buyer has done the transaction. So you have to click in that GST number of that supplier. Then you have to click the B2B invoices button, and it will contain all the B2B invoices with that supplier, and that will show that what the supplier has what the GST related information supplier has entered in the GST portal. So basically, when the businesses from the buyer side, when they see that these are the information uploaded by the supplier side and they match those information with their invoices which they have got from the supplier. In case there are some missing invoices from the supplier side, then they discuss with the supplier and tell them to correct the information or upload those invoices so that they get the GST credit correctly. Now comes to the audit part. So basically what happens that in audit, when audit from the buyer side, so internal audit department of the buyer, when they are taking some purchases which happened for the GST credit review, so they will pick up some samples purchases and they will ask whether the GST credit has been taken. So how the GST credit can be taken? When you do the GST related purchases, buyer do the GST related purchases, then the separate entry, generally what will happen, that separate entry will go to the GST related account, which will track the GST credits. So what you need to do, you need to take some sample purchases where the GST related accounts have been posted for the GST purchases, and you need to verify. You need to verify from the returns which has been filed by the buyer side whether the GST credit has been actually taken for those purchases and whether it has been taken from the correct amount. Also, you need to take the invoices, some of the those invoices, and see that whether the GST credit GST which has been charged matches with the entries which has been done and the value for which credit has been taken from the return. Another thing comes up, there are some suppliers who are infrequent suppliers or one-time supplier or small supplier. So what happens that Amazons prefer not to do the GST related information and to enter in the GST entry in the their system, because what can happen that when you enter do the GST related post the entry for the GST, then default will be taking the credit. And that might happen that supplier with whom you have the infrequent purchases or you don't have the regular relation, you don't have the control on that supplier. So what can happen that that supplier has not entered the GST related information in his or her GST returns, and you don't have the control, so you cannot compel that supplier. So what happens that the organization will not post the GST entry, but at the time of the annual reconciliation process, what happens that you need to take the GST credit for any supply, any purchase or sell before the 31st September of the next 30th September of the next financial year. So it is before that 30th September, the one annual reconciliation is done by the supplier buyer side, buyer tax team. So what they will do, they will open the GST 2-year return and they will verify whether the supplier has entered that information or not entered that information. So because you don't have the control on the supplier side, so what you will do, whatever the chip has been put in the GST 2A will be entered in the, will be for those entries, the credit will be taken in the GST return. Now again comes that whether that supplier should, whether the buyer should leave that the GST credit which has not been entered by the supplier, infrequent supplier. So it's not that they should leave those things. They can raise those points so that next purchases, in fact, infrequent purchases happen, then the supplier is more careful in uploading the GST related information. Also, they can strengthen their process, supplier can strengthen their, buyer can strengthen their process. So there might be a reason that when the GST and then supplier issued the GST invoice, infrequent suppliers issued the GST invoices, the information provided was not correct, GST number provided was not correct, various could be loophole could be, then the policy could be formulated when the infrequent purchases happen, that how to ensure what could be the process refinement so that we can get the GST credit from the next. So when you do the audit review process for these infrequent purchases, so you need to verify that from the GST return and whether the GST credit has been taken, whether the matches, yes, that GST credit matches with the invoices which has been raised by the supplier. If GST credit has not been taken, then this could be the point, and these are the substantial number of cases, then this could be the points, and you could ask for the root cause for that, and on that basis you can give the recommendation that how to strengthen the process so that the GST credits are received on the infrequent purchases. So that's all from my side. Thanks for joining the session. I will be coming with the next session soon. Please subscribe. If you like my video, then please subscribe to my video, and so that you can get the frequent updates on my new videos. Thanks.